My name is Aaron Sumrall. I'm a county extension agent for Texas AgriLife Extension for the part of the A&M University system. Right now, currently in San Jacinto County, and I'm also a PhD candidate at Texas A&M University in College Station. Well, another, a couple of more things that you need to think about in your feral pig management is the type of catch gates that you're going to use and the type of bait that you're thinking about incorporating into that trapping design or that trapping system. First thing is your catch gate. If you don't have, much like the rest of the trap designs, if you don't have any confidence in the catch gate, you're not going to use it. Or if you don't use it, that means you're going to be much less efficient in your feral hog removal efforts whenever you have to depend on other legal means, which being hunting, snares, your dogs, and possibly aerial gunning for other legal options. Most all land managers and resource managers will agree that the trapping efforts should be the foundation of any feral pig removal efforts that you should incorporate. But on your catch gates, many different designs, many different shapes. Many people have seen the Kerrville rooter gates with several different modifications to that, like the Missouri trigger. This design tip is what we call as a saloon door. There's several different types of saloon doors. This one being a recessed saloon door, where it's recessed at 45 degrees from the face of the trap. Other saloon doors will rest flush with the face of the trap. And basically, the name of the trap is just like what it says it is. It's a saloon door. The animals are able to enter the trap, but they're not able to exit the trap because of some type of stopping mechanism on the door itself. So catch gates are going to be your option. Whatever you have the confidence in, use it to the full ability, but don't be afraid to change if it stops working for you. Another thing you need to think about at catch gates is do not put a catch gate into a trapping design that's going to present some type of visual barrier. So nothing real bulky, nothing with solid walls. If it's a Kerrville rooter gate and the gate is only 3 foot tall or so, the remainder of the trap, don't put any solid walls, solid faces in there like plywood or something like that. It's going to present a visual barrier for those hogs. So making sure too that you can give them a free line of sight to that trigger, to that bait, or seeing what they've got. Some other triggers are going to be like your guillotine triggers that just drop straight down. So those triggers, typically, whenever that gate falls, what you have in that gate is all you're going to have in that, or what you have in that trap is all you're going to have in that trap. Whereas with your Kerrville rooter gates, if they're constructed the right way, and with your saloon door trap, those animals are still able to enter that trap once the gate is initially closed. Where your guillotine type triggers or trap doors, you're done pretty much whenever that trap falls or when that gate falls. The next thing is on your bait. Basically, there's about as many bait options out there that people have claimed that work as there are trap designs. But use a bait that you're confident in again too. Many people out there use just your typical soured corn. Soured corn, the souring of that corn will remove some of your non-target species to a certain degree, like deer or raccoons or something like that. But be aware that in heavy mass production times of the year, your soured grains may not work nearly as well. So in those times of the year, you may want to think about either delaying your trapping efforts or changing your bait to something that they desire more than what the natural food supply is. And in that situation, you may want to incorporate vegetables or something like that, maybe that are being discarded from your local produce in your local grocery store, or it could be in your local bakery, throwing pastries away or something like that. Anything to change that up. But in your base bait, with that being a soured corn, if it's still working but it's decreasing in efficiency, one thing you may be able to do to change that is to add something to that. That may be just a pint of honey to a large volume of bait, or it could be that you want to add some grape or strawberry flavoring or something like that. Just something to change that bait up. But on your baits, be ready to modify those baits as those animals start dropping in their readiness to take that bait up. Again, that's what your cameras are going to be able to tell you. Cameras are going to tell you more than what you can find out with your own eyes. Now, with baiting, another thing that you may want to think of incorporating in your trap design whenever you have problems with deer or raccoons is to bury your bait. You bury your bait and cover it with just a small amount of dirt. Sometimes less than 3 inches is sufficient. With some of your bait remaining on the surface of the ground, those non-targets may pick that up, but as long as that hog can smell that bait, they're going to dig that bait up. They'll find a way to get to that bait. and your trapping efficiencies will go up by removing that non-target animal staying loitering in that trap for very long and consuming the majority of your baits. So again, be willing to modify and to adapt into what the cameras are telling you, what your trap catch efficiencies are telling you. Change up. Those animals are ready to be trapped. It's just sometimes you may have to modify what your approach is in order to catch that animal.